गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स मैम, वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ हैलोजेंस। हैलोजेंस आर रिएक्ट्स विद नंबर ऑफ कंपोनेंट्स लाइक ए वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स, ऑक्सीजन एंड हाइड्रोजन। ओके, आर इट इज फॉर्म इंट्रा हैलोजन कंपाउंड्स। ओके, सो नाउ केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज हैलोजेंस, केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ हैलोजेंस। ओवरऑल इट इज रिएक्ट्स विद द हैलोजेंस रिएक्ट्स विद द मेटल्स। ओके, हैलोजेंस रिएक्ट्स विद द मेटल्स। What are halogens? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. So these four elements are called halogens. Suppose for example we are taking magnesium metal. This magnesium metal is reacts with the bromine. Okay, so magnesium metal reacts with the bromine to form MgBr2. Means magnesium bromide. Okay, magnesium bromide. Okay, or suppose sodium is reacts with the chlorine. Sodium is reacts with the chlorine to form 2NaCl. Okay, sodium reacts with the chlorine. Sodium is the metal. Okay, this metal reacts with chlorine to form sodium chloride. Okay, or suppose Fe. Fe is the iron. It is also metal. So this metal is also reacts with the chlorine to form FeCl3. Okay, FeCl3 means ferric chloride. Okay, so iron reacts with the chlorine to form FeCl3. FeCl3 means ferric chloride. Okay, or suppose aluminium. Aluminium is also metal. Okay, suppose Al. This aluminium also reacts with the chlorine to form AlCl3. Okay, aluminium chloride or aluminium trichloride. Okay, what is the formula? 3Cl2 2Cl3. Okay, or 2Al 2Al. Okay, overall metals reacts with halogens to form their metal halides. Okay, suppose magnesium bromide or magnesium chloride or sodium chloride or sodium bromide or ferric chloride, aluminium trichloride. So they are all compounds. Okay, so overall suppose first group elements like a lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, they are all components, first group components. Overall these first group components to form, suppose lithium chloride, okay, or lithium fluoride, or lithium bromide, okay, or sodium chloride, or sodium fluoride, or sodium bromide, or sodium iodide. So overall each element, each metal, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, so these are all alkali metals. These alkali metals reacts with the halogens to form their halides. Okay, to form their halides. So it is reacts with the metals. Okay, next further Next further, halogens reacts with the hydrogen. Okay, halogens reacts with the hydrogens. Each element, like a fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, each element reacts with hydrogen to form their halide. Suppose, for example, hydrogen is reacts with the chlorine to form hydrochloric acid. Okay, or suppose hydrogen is reacts with the fluorine to form HF, hydrochloric acid, hydrogen fluoride, or hydrogen bromide, or hydrogen iodide. Okay, so overall, these are all hydrogen halides. Okay, so these components, all components contain just like acidic nature. Okay, which nature? Acidic nature. The acidic nature is like a hydrogen fluoride less than, hydrochloric acid less than, HBr less than HI. Okay, so very high acidic nature of compound hydrogen iodide, very low acidic nature of compound hydrogen fluoride. Okay, overall, hydrogen reacts with halogens to form their halides. Suppose hydrogen reacts with fluorine to form HF, hydrogen fluoride, and hydrogen reacts with chlorine to form hydrochloric acid, HCl. Okay, at the same time, hydrogen reacts with bromine to form HBr, and next to form hydrogen iodide. Okay, overall, they are all components acidic nature of compounds. What is the acidic nature order? Hydrogen fluoride less than, hydrochloric acid less than, hydrogen bromide less than hydrogen iodide. Okay, so it is the reaction with the hydrogen. Okay, next, in this lesson we have discussed about preparation of chlorine. So it is very important, preparation of chlorine. So first method, it is very important method. So that is a Dekon process. Dekon process. What is the Dekon process? So overall, when we have taken hydrochloric acid, this hydrochloric acid is reacts with the oxygen at a 723 Kelvin temperature in the presence of CuCl2. Okay, when we have taken hydrochloric acid, this hydrochloric acid is reacts with the oxygen at 723 Kelvin temperature in the presence of CuCl2. To form this reaction, this is 4Cl, means just like 2Cl2. Okay, to form chlorine in this reaction. So next to 2, 4H. 4H means 2H2O. Okay, 2H2O. So chlorine and a water molecule. It is a very important reaction, Dekon process. What is that Dekon process? When we have taken hydrochloric acid, this hydrochloric acid reacts with the oxygen at 723 Kelvin temperature in the presence of CuCl2. To form this reaction, chlorine and water molecules. Okay, it is one of the best preparation of chlorine. Next, further, second process, electrolysis process. So in this electrolysis process or method, when we have taken NaCl solution, so NaCl solution is called a brine solution. Okay, so simply NaCl is called salt, but when we have taken sodium chloride solution, this sodium chloride solution is called a brine solution. So electricity is passed through the brine solution. So first, this sodium chloride is converted to two ions. That is the 2 Na+ ion and 2 Cl- ion. Okay, so Na+ ion positive ion, it is also cation. Cl- ion negative ion, it is anion. Okay, next further, these 2 Cl- chloride ions, these chloride ions to give 2 electrons and at the same time to form chlorine gas. Okay, so this reaction is called deelectronation reaction. Okay, so released the electrons, deelectronation reaction. Okay, or gain of electrons, electronation reaction. Okay, so it is a which reaction? Deelectronation reaction. Means just like in this reaction released the electrons. Okay, so this is one of the best process to preparation of chlorine gas. Okay, listen. So electrolysis process, when in this reaction we have taken brine solution, sodium chloride solution is called a brine solution. When electricity is passed through the brine solution, so sodium chloride is converted to 2 ions. That is number one Na+ ion and second one Cl- ion. These chloride ions is give the electrons or release the electrons to form chlorine gas. Okay, so it is the electrolysis method. Next method, so next method, laboratory method. Overall, chlorine is formed by laboratory method. So overall, in this method we have taken MnO2. So MnO2 means manganese dioxide. Okay, MnO2 means manganese dioxide. So this manganese dioxide is react with the hydrochloric acid. Okay, hydrochloric acid. To form this reaction, Mn2Cn to form MnCl2. Okay, Mn and our 2 chlorine atoms to form MnCl2 manganese chloride. And next further in this reaction, so remaining 2 chlorine, okay, so Cl2 chlorine gas, 2 Cl 2, next further 4H and O2, so 2H2O water molecules. Okay, so it is the laboratory method. So in this method we have taken MnO2. MnO2 means manganese dioxide. This manganese dioxide is reacts with the hydrochloric acid to form in this reaction MnCl2. MnCl2 means manganese chloride. And next chlorine, next further water molecules. Okay, next very important method. So in this method we have taken MnO2. MnO2 means manganese dioxide, and at the same time sodium chloride. Okay, sodium chloride and H2SO4. Okay, H2SO4 means sulfuric acid. When manganese dioxide is reacts with the sodium chloride and H2SO4 means sulfuric acid to form the reaction MnCl2 means manganese chloride, okay, or manganese dichloride. Okay, next to further in this reaction 2NaHSO4. So 2NaHSO4 means sodium hydrogen sulfate. Okay, sodium hydrogen sulfate. Next, in this reaction to form chlorine gas and water molecules. Okay, next in this reaction to form chlorine gas and water molecules. Okay, listen. Manganese dioxide. This manganese dioxide is reacts with the sodium chloride and next H2SO4 sulfuric acid to form the reaction. First compound MnCl2. So MnCl2 means manganese chloride. Next NaHSO4 means sodium hydrogen sulfate. Next further chlorine gas. Next water molecules. Okay, so it is a preparation of chlorine gas. So overall it is a very important preparation of chlorine. Number one, Dickon process. Second one, electrolysis process. Third one, so laboratory method. Okay, so next further physical and chemical properties of chlorine gas. Okay, already we know that, just like what is the physical properties of chlorine. So overall chlorine is a gaseous compound. Okay, so chlorine is a gaseous compound. So it is a overall greenish yellow color. Okay, which color? Greenish yellow color. So it is a fungus smell. Okay, fungus smell. And it is soluble in water. Okay, chlorine gas is soluble in water. Suppose for example, chlorine gas is soluble in water. To form this reaction, hydrochloric acid and hypochlorous acid. Okay, when chlorine gas is soluble in water molecules, to form this reaction hydrochloric acid and the next further hypochlorous acid. Okay, what is the physical properties? Chlorine is a gaseous compound. It is a greenish yellow color and it contains fungus smell and it is soluble in water molecules. When this chlorine gas soluble in water molecules to form hydrochloric acid and hypochlorous acid. Okay, it is a physical properties of chlorine gas. Next further, chemical properties of chlorine gas. It is very important. So chemical properties of chlorine. Overall chlorine gas is reacts with a number of components like metals, non-metals, alcoholic components like basic components. Okay, so different types of metals, non-metals. Okay, now first of all it is reacts with metals. Okay, chlorine reacts with the metals. Suppose, for example, it is a very important reaction, iron. So iron is the metal. This iron is reacts with the chlorine to form in this reaction FeCl3. FeCl3 means ferric chloride. Okay, ferric chloride. Already we know that. So, or suppose sodium. So this sodium is reacts with the chlorine to form 2NaCl. So means sodium chloride. Okay, sodium reacts with the chlorine to form sodium chloride. Next, suppose aluminium. It is also, you know that. This aluminium is reacts with the chlorine to form AlCl3. So aluminium trichloride. Or suppose, so not only sodium, lithium or potassium, rubidium, cesium. So they are all metals reacts with the chlorine to form the chloride. Okay, to form the chloride. So it is a reacts with the metals. So this reaction is very important reaction for exam purpose. Okay, so iron or ferrous. Okay, iron or ferrous. So this ferrous is reacts with the chlorine to form the reaction ferric chloride. What is the formula? FeCl3. So FeCl3 is ferric chloride. Okay, ferric chloride. So next, second one reacts with the non-metals. Non-metals. Okay, suppose for example phosphorus. Phosphorus, sulfur. So these are all components is non-metals. Suppose phosphorus. This phosphorus is reacts with the chlorine. Phosphorus reacts with chlorine to form PCl3. So PCl3 means phosphorus trichloride. Okay, phosphorus trichloride. So overall, what is the equation? So P4 plus 6Cl2 gives rise to 4PCl3. Okay, PCl3 means phosphorus trichloride. Okay, at the same time, suppose P4 phosphorus. This phosphorus is reacts with the chlorine to form the reaction PCl5. Okay, phosphorus reacts with the chlorine, highly quantity of chlorine, to form the reaction PCl5, phosphorus pentachloride. Okay, so or suppose chlorine reaction with the sulfur also. Okay, chlorine reaction with the sulfur also. Suppose sulfur contains AC8. This sulfur reacts with the chlorine. Sulfur reacts with the chlorine to form S2Cl2. So sulfur dichloride. Okay, S2Cl2. Overall, so sulfur reacts with the chlorine to form in this reaction S2Cl2. Okay, disulfur dichloride. Okay, it is a reaction with the non-metals. Okay, further class we are discussing about a reaction with sodium hydroxide, a reaction with the remaining components. Okay.